He's doing a jerk. He's doing a fly. Don't play him cheap, cause you know he ain't shy. He's doing a monkey, the mashed potato, the jump back jack. See you later, alligator. Ain't no drag. Papa's got a brand new bag. Good morning. That was my rendition of James Brown this morning. How y'all doing? Good morning. Good afternoon. Good evening to you, family. Whatever side of the diaspora that you may be on. Come on, let's talk that stuff today. I saw a very interesting article. And this is personally going out to Boosie, who I'm sure don't remember. I met him several times. He comes to Milwaukee a lot, and an acquaintance of mine, Homer Blow, who, congratulations, Homer, was just up for the DJ, I guess, of the Year award, right? Or media personality. I mean, Homer is the hardest working man in Milwaukee. I mean, really. Homer Blow. Anyway, we brought Boosie here, like I told y'all before, because when Mike was running for alderman, you know, to just energize the place, Boosie got friends here. We called him and he came. I mean, he's a real down to earth man. So I never had a problem with him, and I can overlook some of the things that people are trying to make a big deal out of that he said, because I know that's not his heart. Okay, so with that being said, it is circulating around the internet that Aviana has a little girlfriend. Okay, however, in my opinion, when it comes to young people, and you know, in the 20s, 19, I mean, they still experimenting, and you know, it's okay. So for those that are clowning her, and obviously she don't care, because most of the time when you in your 20s, you don't give a damn about what nobody think. Okay? But what's important is that, Boosie, you know they gonna try to clown you and say this is your karma because they think you hate gay people, which I know couldn't be further from the truth. I know personally that's so far away from who you are that I hope you handle this okay, because this is different. And I always laugh because I think Aviana looked more like you than any of your kids. Your firstborn and your daughter, who grew up in love and trying to imitate you as well. So, which made her a little rough around the edges. I can clearly relate to Aviana. Black Ivy, I think that's what they call her. Poison Ivy. All I want to say is, regardless of what you said about, it doesn't matter, because I know your intent behind what you said about Gabrielle Union and Dwayne Wade's son. I understand your passion. Let him, and I understand as a translator that you meant, in my opinion, now I could be wrong, but the way I gathered and received it and filtered it was that don't do that to him right now. Let him be able to make up his own mind. And I feel exactly the same way. Although I support Dwayne and Gabrielle to the fullest, because it's not easy having a child that is gay, that is different. Most people's parents disown them. I can show you so many kids whose parents told them don't come back home no more. Or insulting things like, I can't even say it on internet without being flagged. Some people have been so abusive to their children when they find out that they might be experimenting with sex. And I thought that's what growing up was all about. And if you teach your child to be safe, and if you teach your child what you should be, you hope that they're going to make the right choices. Nothing is guaranteed. But one thing is, you have to accept them for who they are. And I feel that about Boosie. I could be wrong, but that's what I feel about him as a father and as a man. So I know they're clowning him on the internet, and I think that that is just insane, because nothing should come between a love of your child, your offspring, somebody you produced, and the person that is the person you produce have the right to have their own life without being ridiculed, called names, being talked down to or made feel less than. All those things are not necessary, and they shouldn't be tolerated. You know, some of us could think of some of the things that those that are in recovery that I know I can't. I'm just going to speak by my own experience. My father have said so many hurtful, brutal things to me that I didn't even want to see him. Some of the things he said hurt me to my very core, where I could feel my stomach and tied in knots. Okay? And the same with my mother. And I'm talking about a young person who wasn't even an adult yet, or barely an adult, if I was. The fact of the matter is, as parents, we have the power to just mess up our whole offspring's understanding. And why would we want to do that if we want them to be healthy, productive people? Because they don't want to do what we say, or they didn't turn out the way we wanted them to be? That is so narcissistic and so insane. And another shout out I want to give to is Godfrey. Godfrey, I really appreciate you for being so vulnerable and open about mental health. Because coming out of show business is one of the hardest things that we get to deal with. I know a lot of people in show business because, you know, I hang around with a lot of comedians and musicians and things of that nature. But a lot of them don't want to go to therapy because they think they're scared they're going to lose their funny, or scared they're going to lose their... Because no, what it is you got to deal with all that damn trauma. And or even if it's not, why do you do the things you do? And most of us have never had to think on that deep of a level. That's why some of the greatest voices that you hear is because of some of such pain. Such pain that they experienced growing up. So... I know that's a little off the subject, but what I want to say is, I think it's Proverbs 18, what it said, life and death is in the power of the tongue. So be kind with your words. Be kind with them. And if you can't be as kind as you like, remember, what did Iyanla Van Zandt say? Honesty without any compassion is just brutality. So we got a lot of people that is good for that. And so with that being said, shout out to Iviana. Shout out Black Ivy, Poison Ivy, whatever they call you, little honey. And your pop. And may y'all, you know, just chill on this revelation and not let the outside forces penetrate your love. I'll see y'all in the next video. If you like what you hear, please like, please subscribe, please share the channel, please donate to the channel, please watch the commercials. All these things are so much appreciate it. They so appreciate it. And I'll see you in the next one.